Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Wednesday, March 14th, 2012. At 7:30 a.m. on the East Coast, stock index futures are slightly above fair value, while we've got a negative tone to commodities. Crude oil is down only about 25 cents, but we do have gold down about $35. So we are looking for a mixed open Wednesday morning at 9:30. Now, yesterday I mentioned that it was the calm before the storm. Monday, the NASDAQ closed unchanged, so that was the calm. The storm I was expecting to come Thursday with the release of the bank stress test. We're, you know, looking for some volatility expansion. And we got that yesterday. I was expecting it to be fairly quiet. It's usually a quiet day up until the release of the Fed minutes at 2:15. And then you've got volatility expansion after 2:15. But it was actually fairly quiet after the Fed minutes came out. It was a positive day all around. And then suddenly we had a leak of the bank stress test results by JP Morgan. They released some news, and so next thing you know, the banks took off. And so here's what the market looked like. We opened higher yesterday, and throughout the day we traded higher, but we're fairly steady. And then you can see this is the 230 to 330 bar. That's when the news was leaked, and there's the 3:30 to 4 o'clock bar. And so nice big up move, a melt up in financial stocks on both sides of the border. That's the U.S. This is a 60-minute chart of the TSX Financial Services Group. They moved higher yesterday as well. So real melt up in financial services stocks ahead of the stress test results that were supposed to be released on Thursday. But they're public now, so that news is out, and we'll have to see if the market can find follow through to the upside. Next up, let's take a look at the pieces of the puzzle. A lot of people are doing an analysis on what the VIX is doing and what the S&P 500 is doing. The VIX is on a sell signal, S&P 500 on a buy signal. That's the simple analysis. Yesterday, we started out lower on the VIX and moved higher, didn't close at the low of the day, while the index actually closed at the high of the day. So a little bit of divergence there that people are watching. The NASDAQ 100 VIX didn't make a new low yesterday, while the index made a new high. So a little bit of a divergence there as well. The TSX still on a sell signal. VIX is still on a sell signal as well. Of course, gold stock's not a big help for the TSX right now. Bonds moved lower yesterday, so we saw some money flow out of bonds. Closed right at support there, so not a major breakdown, but certainly going in the right direction to support higher stock prices. The risk-off trade is still on. We've got money still flowing back into the U.S. dollar, out of the euro. Canadian dollar sitting right on the upper channel line right now, still on a buy signal, no change there. Taking a look at commodity ETFs, no change for coal. No change for crude oil. We still need to close above 41.03. No change for gasoline. No change for natural gas. Copper moved up sharply yesterday and is now back on a buy signal. No change for gold, and gold's down sharply in the pre-market this morning. And no change for silver, and silver's down in the pre-market this morning. Next up, let's look at some stock and index charts, starting with the TSX. We traded in the channel yesterday. We had nice up move, but not enough to give us a buy signal. We need to close above 12,567 to give us a buy signal on Wednesday. Energy stocks not really helping here. Financial services stocks leading the market higher. New high for this index. We actually had the Bank of Montreal get back on a buy signal finally yesterday. Bank of Nova Scotia is on a buy signal. No change for CIBC. No change for National Bank making a new high here. No change for the Royal Bank making a new high here. And no change for the TD Bank making a new high here. Looking at gold stocks, no change, a new low for this particular move, and we'll expect to see lower prices again on Wednesday. Similar situation for materials, for metals and mining. And last up, no change for the Venture Exchange. Looking at the U.S. market, a big up move yesterday for the S&P 500 and certainly traded through the 1375 level. No change for the NASDAQ, no change for the Russell, and no change for the ZACS. We'll be watching those last two indexes to see if they can take out recent highs. Now, it was all about bank stocks yesterday, so we saw Bank of America shoot higher. Now, this stock had been trading in a very tight range for the last couple of weeks and then shot up to the next level of resistance yesterday. So we'll have to see see if we can break out above 859. For Citicorp, similar situation. It was on a buy signal going into yesterday's move. Nice big pop. Still needs to get above 3750. Looking at JP Morgan, big pop yesterday. Looking for it to break out above 4375. For Wells Fargo, similar situation. Nice big pop yesterday. So lots of money went back into financial services stocks. Couple that I'm involved in, I'm still short CME Group, no major change yesterday. Goldman Sachs, huge update yesterday. I was short the stock going into yesterday, so obviously I've got to take that loss, cover that short, and go long today. Don't feel great about going long, but I have to do what I have to do. And Visa, no major change yesterday for Visa, so we can still hold our position there. Taking a look at the transports, they were up sharply yesterday as well, being led by UPS. So now we've got all the major Dow indexes back on buy signals. Taking a look at our roadmap for Wednesday, VIX certainly very oversold here. And so that when you've got the VIX oversold, you're looking for a buy signal in the VIX and a potential down move in the stock market. Not too worried unless the VIX starts trading above $18. For the TSX, we came off the bottom of the panic zones, moved up. The open gap stopped us, the 12,500 level. We were able to trade above that yesterday, but still stuck to the flypaper channel, so not a major breakout there, and still stuck to the moving average lines. We're seeing a breakout above the 100-hour moving average right now, and so we've been able to trade above the 250 and finally above the 100-hour, and so that's positive for the TSX. So we're going to remain positive on the Canadian stock market on Wednesday as long as the TSX does not start trading below 12,462. Looking at the S&P 500, obviously panic buying yesterday, popped out above the top of the panic zones, but no early warning signals, so nothing to worry about right now. So we're going to remain bullish on the U.S. stock market on Wednesday as long as the S&P 500 does not start trading below 1377.58. Okay, folks, that's all for Wednesday morning. We've got some new orders to place, some short positions to cover, some long positions to take. As a short-term trader, these are exciting times. As a long-term investor, you know, this is not the time and place I'd want to be putting new money into the market. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again next on Thursday morning.